ready? Go ahead.
Do you feel powerful when you have got us with main source of strength? My main verse is Luke 1:37. You will get to know why did I choose the verse and the application to believers and to the unbelievers. God is the main source of strength for every single one of his sons. My main verse is Luke 1:37 that says, for with God nothing shall be impossible. The theme of this verse is strength, and I chose it because God has to be the main source of strength for every one of us. Luke was a really good writer. His gospel is well written and gives a good point of view of the life of Jesus Christ. The summary of this chapter, it talks about how the birth of Jesus and John the Baptist is foretold. And the main point of the gospel is that Jesus has come to save all of his believers, not only the people of Israel, the Jews. And I took this information from the Bible English Standard Version. Now some background from Luke. Luke was the travel companion and colleague of Paul, and he also may be the only non-Jewish writer in the New Testament. He wrote his gospel between 50 and 60 AD, and it records the lifetime of Jesus Christ that was from 60 BC to 30 AD. Most of the locations of these events were in northern Israel, and I took this information from the Complete Guide to the Bible. The main verse I chose can be related to the following verses that share the same theme as mine. Can you please take out your handouts right now? This handout will talk about the background information about my three cross references. My first cross reference is Joshua 1:9, and it states that we have to be strong and courageous because God is always with us no matter what. My second cross reference is Psalm 28:7. It states that if my spirit has confidence in God, he will help me. That my last cross references, you may know this one, it's very popular, and it's from the book of Philippians, and it says, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. A good example of story that has the same theme strength as my verse is the Battle of Thermopylae. This battle was the second war between the Greeks and the Persians. It was held in Thermopylae, or also known as the Pump Gates. And right here will be the Pump Gates. Leonidas is called the leader of the Spartans, then 300 Spartans and some other Greek groups from different city states to there. The Persians were fighting with around 50,000 soldiers, while the Greeks only fought with 6,000 for this. Leonidas stopped his troops right here, expecting that the narrow passage would stop the Persian attack. This is Leonidas. And for 2 days, the Greeks were able to stop the attack, but then there was another route over the mountains, and the Persians found it, so they surrounded the Greeks and killed all of them. So the Greeks did something that seemed impossible, and they did it possible. Why? Because they had a reason. The reason was to protect Greece. And they used that reason as the main source of strength. And I took this information from history.com. The message of the verse can be applied to believers and also to the unbelievers. The application to the believers would be like, we have to use God as our main source of strength. So when we use him as our main source of strength, we can use him as our motivation and do whatever we propose to. Then to the unbelievers would be, they have to find a main source of strength. It can be a reason, like the Greeks did, a person, or another God. Once they have this main source of strength, they can use it as their motivation and do whatever they propose to. And personally, I chose this verse because it gave me strength when I first came here. It was tough, living home, and having a holy language, we have God as our main source of strength, we will be able to accomplish everything we propose to. The message of Luke 1:37 can be applied to everyone. It can be believers and unbelievers. If God is with us, nothing will be impossible.
Okay. Thank you very much. Let's give him a round of applause.
Thank you, Dieter.